Hey, what's up, everyone? If you haven't checked out Simone's video on how to use Typebot Callbacks, I highly recommend you give it a look. As you can see here, you can enhance your Typebots to a completely new level using images and, in his case, videos. So what I've decided to do is to remix this really cool idea and just really try to figure out how to make our Typebots a little bit more dynamic based off of user input. All right, so here is my version. And you can see in the background, I'm not using a video. In fact, I'm using just a regular image, but with a Ken Burns effect, which gives it that animation. And in this particular case, what I'd like to show you is just the way the images change in the background based off of the user selection. So here is a customer feedback survey. It says, "Hi, Satoshi. How did your stay at Beach Retreat compare to your expectations?" So if I put a bit worse than I expected, then the image is going to switch to the director of customer experience. And then the survey says, "Uh-oh, sorry, we missed the mark. Where did things go wrong?" And then it says, "We'll pass your note to our director of guest experience right away. His name is Dave." So then the user puts in whatever complaint or frustration that they experienced. And then the image is going to switch in the background. And then this ends the survey, right? So this is a simple flow of how a customer experience survey could look like. But really, the possibilities are almost endless, right? You're only limited by the constraints of Typebot callbacks. If you were like me, you were probably scratching your head and didn't even know callbacks were even an option within Typebot. So let's take a look at what callbacks are. So in the description in the documentation, it says, if you need to trigger events on your parent website, when the user interacts with the bot or your Typebot, you can use the following callbacks. So to take a step back, a callback is pretty much executing functions within a function. So here you can see in the code example that there are four different functions, right? And the functions represent events or behavior that happens within your Typebot. So the first function is on new input block. The next one is on answer. The next is on init, or when your Typebot is initialized, and then on end is when your Typebot flow ends. So you can imagine these as sort of events that happen within your Typebot. So whenever a new input block comes in, then you can execute some code. And it looks like this. And I have no idea what input block.id is, but what's helpful is to kind of map or reverse engineer what that could mean with this console.log message. So you'll notice that input dot or input block.id is just a long string of characters. And then similarly, answer.message, I had no idea where that was coming from, but if you kind of mess around with your Typebot and then look at your console log, you'll see that it matches whatever your user input within their answer, right? It could be a text, like an open text field, or it can be like the selection of a button with text in it, right? That'll be captured here. And then on the bot initialized, that's pretty much when your bot starts. So that's executed right away. So what I did for my particular example, I only used two of these events or two of these functions. I used it whenever the user input an answer, and then on the end of my Typebot flow. So if we hop over to my editor, you'll see that I have a super simple website. In fact, it's pretty much just one page with four different images, of which I think I only used three of them. So the next part might seem daunting because it is quite code intensive, right? You have to pretty much create functions that interact with your website or whatever creative assets that you have. However, ChatGPT can do the heavy lifting for you. All you need to do is just kind of have a good understanding of how Typebot works, what to access from Typebot, and then create or tell ChatGPT to create code that can take that information from Typebot and do some sort of behavior on your website. So in my example, all I really wanted to do was just change the background image whenever a user selected a certain option. So if we go back to the Typebot survey, the image that you see in the background, that's just an image that I decided to use because it looks pretty nice. And then on this event, when the user inputs their answer, then there's logic in the background, right? That looks like this on answer. So on answer, the code is going to execute. And based off of that, the image is going to get swapped from the background image, which is BG-1, to sorry. And then what gives the web page that smooth transition between images? That's all done with CSS. So if we hop back over to my editor, you can see that I inserted the following styles. And this is essentially what gives it that different animation or that smooth transition. To be clear, ChatGPT did most of the heavy lifting, right? That's probably not a shocker to you. The contribution that I had was to be able to understand how Typebot callbacks work, figure out what to look for, right? When something happens in Typebot, then I want the following code to execute on my website, which is the images to get swapped. If you can convey that to ChatGPT, you can certainly get this done. No problem. I found the trickier part was actually the CSS and trying to get the animation that I want within my web page. But that's it in a nutshell. This is my remix of Simone's idea. So I want to give a special thanks to Simone for sharing that really cool video in our Facebook group. And also opening up this other side of Typebot that I had no idea existed, because this can certainly change or enhance your Typebot for the better. You can make it much more dynamic. You can kind of map the website feeling to the feeling of your Typebot. It's a really cool dynamic that you can put together here. All right, so if you have any questions, please put them in the comment section, and I look forward to hearing from you. See you in the next video.